Hey y'all, I'm Kayla. Welcome to my channel. If you are new here, if you're not new here, what's going on? So if you saw that thumbnail and the title, then y'all already know the vibes for this video. It's going to be a hair tutorial slash review. So Hermosa sent me over this super cute 5x5 body wave wig. It is 24 inches and it's also 220 density. I feel like this is the perfect summer wig just to throw on, okay? So if you need a good wig for the summer, I suggest you go ahead and stick around and let's go ahead and get into this install. So as I stated earlier in the video, today's video is sponsored by Hermosa Hair. This is me just unboxing everything that they sent me. So they sent over a wig cap. They also sent over lashes. It actually came with 2 pack of lashes. That was new. Really loved that. They sent over the wig band. And then this is me just taking a wig out of the packaging. And as y'all can see, this is what the lace is looking like. Y'all, the lace comes pre-cut, okay? And they already like helped you with the baby hairs if you have trouble with like put a nose out. So this is what it looks like straight out the bag. And when I say this is giving true body wave, it's giving true body wave. So since the knots were pretty thick on this, I decided that it was really important for me to go ahead and bleach them. So these are the products that I use to bleach mine, and I like to only use one scoop, and then you want to try to get that bleach as thick as you can. I put too much developer, so mine was a little runny, but you know, that's fine. I can make do with it. And you see, like, the wig comes with a wig band in it. I think that's really important when it comes to closures, because that's what keeps that lace down. But since I was about to go ahead and bleach it, I didn't want to get bleach on it, so I went ahead and took it out. So I love the fact that you can put it in and take it out. So here I am just gliding it on there. And then, boom, here's the next day. I like to go ahead and, like, bleach my knots, wash the hair, do all of that stuff, and then let it sit overnight and let it just dry. So this is what it looks like the next day. So these are the knots. This is them bleached. I let the bleach sit for maybe like an hour, and that's how far I got. Then I went ahead and plucked the wig off the cam, and I also did like a little blowout look, because I like to do a little blowout before I get to curling my hair. And once I put it on, as y'all can see, I really didn't even need to do much, but I did need to cut these little bit of tabs off on the side. So that's what y'all see me doing. And honestly, if I wanted to wear this wig straight like this, I really could have, because like, look at it. Like, let's really get into it. But yeah, that's all I really needed to do was just was to just cut off that little excess. And then as y'all can see, like I said, you could even wear this glueless if you wanted to, but I'm just like one of the girls who like to have my wigs glued down, because I like to keep wigs on for a couple of days, okay? So I went ahead and used my Got to Be spray, and I just sprayed a generous amount. Since I wasn't using like glue, this is still considered glueless because it's not real glue, but I go ahead and put a good amount on there. And then I use that headband that they sent over with the wig. When I tell y'all, they sent everything that you need with the wig, so you ain't got to be looking all over the place to find stuff. And I like to tie mine real tight, okay? I don't really use the Velcro in the back because it don't be tight enough. I like to tie it myself. But once I tie it down, I like to go in and do it like all my styling. So here y'all just see me cutting layers in the hair. Y'all, I'm not a hairstylist. I don't portray myself to be a hairstylist. This is at home work. So honestly, I just kind of section my hair off like row by row, if that makes sense. And I just cut. I try to keep the length of the hair though. Like, I don't cut the bottoms of the hair. I just cut it at that like motion. So y'all see, like, it's like going diagonally. Like, I don't really have the terms for this, y'all. Like, I be doing my own hair. Like, this is as good as it gets. You know what I'm saying? This is not cosmetology school, but baby, but we make it work. We make it work. So once I'm done doing all the cutting, I like to go in and just use my wax stick, and then I go in with the hot comb to just get the top as flat as I can. And then once I finish doing that, I just like to go in and curl it. And the kind of curling iron that I used to use like a real small one, but these days I've been using my bigger one. I want to say this is 1 1/4 inch curling irons. And I think curling irons is like the best route when you want to get those big body curls, because that's what we about to go for. So enjoy me curling up this wig. Okay, so once we got all those big body curls in place, I'm gonna go ahead and take the edge band off. And as y'all can see, we're looking pretty good. That thing is melted down. Now, only thing I need to do is make the lace a bit more my skin color. So I like to go in with some bronzer. And my bronzer is just like a tad bit darker than my skin color. So like, since the lace is light and I'm using something darker, it kind of goes directly to my skin color, if that makes sense. And I like to use a lot. I use a lot of that. And as y'all can see, it looks like it's really, really giving scalp now. Then I just go in and like comb out that excess makeup and that excess spray that I put on there, because I don't want it to be hard. And then I go in and pluck it even more. I do like my wigs to be, you know, generously plucked. So keep in mind that this wig does need to be plucked. So you're probably gonna have to do some plucking on and off the head like I did, but it wasn't too hard to do. So then I go ahead and comb out all the curls. I pretty much like just comb until I can't no more. Like, I'm one of those people, like, I'ma comb all the curls out and I'ma push them forward. I'ma make it do what it do. Like, I'ma just play with the curls as much as I possibly can to get them where I want them to be. And as y'all can see how they laying, it's because I have put the layers in my hair. So that's what makes them like also lay that way. So when you want to do some curls, the key to curls is layers. The key to curls is layers. Then I go back in with the hot comb just to get the top real, real flat. And as y'all can see, like, it's honestly giving. Like, this is giving me a baddie, okay? And then I decided, like, okay, I like it like this, but it's just not me if I add a little baby hair, two or three. You know what I'm saying? So I went ahead and put my two little baby hairs in there. So that's what y'all see me doing. I like to use the hot comb to push those forward because I had them going backwards, especially after I had then tied them down or whatever. So I'm going to do the same thing to the other side. As y'all can see, I had too much going on over there, so I had to take some of that away. And then I did the same thing with the hot comb over there. Then you want to always go in and cut the baby hairs. They're kind of like a diagonal. You want them to be like shorter to longer, going from like the inner eyebrow to the outer, if that makes sense. I'll be trying to like find ways to explain stuff to y'all that makes sense and be like real specific at the same time. But then I go in with my got to be gel. You can either use gel or the spray, but I find that using a gel is easier when it comes to doing like the actual baby hair, just because it gives you more like sleekness. It makes them more wet and more easier to move around, if that makes sense as well. But here I am, I did them baby hairs 1,000 times, y'all. When I say it takes me forever to do baby hairs, because I can never get them how I want them to be in the beginning. But of course, like, after trial and error and just doing stuff, because like, look at this, they don't even match up. And then they was too thick. I always know if your baby hairs is too thick, go back in and take some of them things out. Like, it's okay to keep plucking. Pluck until you just feel like you got what you wanted. But here I am just continuously doing them. And then they ended up coming out how I want them to be after a while. I just had to really play around with it. Baby hairs is one of them things you just got to keep practicing if you want it to be perfect for you. So as y'all can see, it took me a little minute, but I got the baby hairs together. And this is the final look. I actually really love this. This is like one of those go-to looks. You can never go wrong with a middle part, and you can never go wrong with some curls. And just look how thick this wig is. Like, it's really hard to come across really good wigs that are thick. Like, look at the shine on the hair. It's so bouncy. It's so beautiful. Like, it is just eating. Like, look at the curls. And honestly, me cutting the layers into this really, really what did it with the curls. But again, this is a 5x5 closure. Like I said, you could glue it down. You could wear it glueless. It's like the perfect summer install. Today's video was sponsored by Hermosa. So shout out to them again for sponsoring today's video. Love, love, love the look. If you ladies want to get this look, make sure you check the description box down below. And I'll have all the details down there for y'all. And I'll catch you guys and girls on the next video. I really hope y'all enjoyed.